Happy Halloween.
Oh, thank you.
Happy Halloween.
She's a ballerina.
No.
Vision for mom?
Cousin.
No, nothing.
You would come here? I really wish she would have told us what her plan was to help Dad. I can't stand all this waiting.
Mom's going on instinct and prayer right now, sis. And she's our best shot.
Well, I doubt that anyone can get through to Dad. Did you feel that?
A ghost.
Ooh. Yeah, a ghost. Or maybe a draft from the door. That was a draft, right?
This host is so twisted.
When's he gonna show his face?
Welcome to the Halloween Big Top, the GC Circus. I am your host and ringmaster, Billy Abbott, and you are the audience. And the show. Trick or treat.
Hey, did I ever tell you that Olivia Newton-John is the hottest woman, like, ever?
Hey, did I ever tell you that maybe you should put those eyes of yours back in your head?
Or somebody, anybody, can put them back in your head for you.
Okay, here's the deal. You won, man. You got the girl. I lost. It's okay. There's no hard feelings on my part anyway. So come on, tell him. Just go have fun. Enjoy it. And as for you, you know, I almost wore the exact same costume. That would have been really embarrassing, wouldn't it, sweetheart?
Okay, here's the plan. We order lots and lots and lots of alcohol, as much as we can. We pour it down the toilet if we have to.
Because we hate booze?
No, because we want to spend as much of that jerk's money as possible.
Come on, Queen. Sweetie, you're supposed to go to the prom before you put out.
I'm an overachiever. I should have known you were throwing this party. Way too cool for these kids to throw.
Oh, come on, you can stop. You already had me and you left me. I have no bitter feelings.
I do toss men aside, don't I?
Mm-hmm. But you've got to keep her if you can keep them.
Which is what you and I both want. So then you have a clear shot at Lily. No, genius idea inviting them both to this party. Putting them in the same room. What are you thinking?
Oh, come on. Trust me, you pretty little queen. I got this one covered.
Oh, is that a text from the guy from webmeet.org?
Yes, it says Fallout Girl has a message from Sunny Crawford.
What does it say?
Well, he wants to know what I'm doing for All Hallows Eve. Well,
invite him here. It's perfect. There's so many people here. And if he's a dork, then... I don't know, you can say you're the dork in leg warmers.
Let's have the candy. All right, let's have the candy right here.
Well, my friend, you really know how to scare it up. You know, Phyllis went out and scoped the houses outside the ranch just to make sure that Summer wouldn't get gypped.
When did you decorate? 2 a.m.? Between the magazine and Newman and everything that's going on with Dad.
It was 3 a.m., actually. And don't let him kid you. He did all of this on his own.
Well, maybe one day Summer will actually appreciate all this work you're doing for her. I just want her to know that work will never come before her.
Yeah, not like our father.
Yeah, even when Dad was around, his head was never really on us.
No, but Mom, there's a different story. No matter what was going on in her life, I always know where we stood with her.
It's
what we got over there?
Yes, the spiders and the eyeballs and the guts. It's so fun. Oh, come on over.
Sounds delicious. Come on, little pirate.
Eyeballs. Let's go and get some guts eyeballs. And stuff.
Guts.
Sounds like fun.
Eyeballs and nuts.
Just, I don't know, I can't stop. I'm thinking about Mom. She's out there fighting for Dad. I should be helping.
Vic, you are. You're making sure that Reed has a mother and father who will never let him down.
Are you still angry at Dad?
I'm just frustrated, you know? I mean, he missed out on us, and now he's missing out on our kids.
They're beautiful, aren't they?
Little Summer, when she put on her costume, she giggled so much that it made her
hiccup. This is the cutest thing I've ever seen. I swear to you, I'll never forget that moment.
Thank the God that they're too little to know how messed up things are right now.
And they won't.
You know something, what Dad? What he wrote in that letter about you? You're an amazing father.
Thanks, Vic. And we have amazing kids. And we are not going to make Dad's mistakes.
You made the move. I'm so proud of you.
Mm-hmm.
I hope he shows and I hope he doesn't.
Excuse me for a second.
Sure thing.
Thanks. We got a code blue over here.
A code blue, huh?
That's right, a code blue. That means a patient is in need of mouth-to-mouth resuscitation.
Oh, well, doctor, please don't let me get in the way.
Oh, no?
Yeah. Oh, wait, what do you say? Sonny is on his way.
You hate this. The party. You're politely biding your time, but when you've had long enough, you and your date, your phone, are going to bail out of here.
I am not dating my phone.
Well, you look pretty attached to me.
Well, it's because I met a guy.
Really? Off that dating site, there was a joke that obviously isn't such a joke anymore?
Yeah, and he's funny.
I'm thinking he's compensating. I'm thinking probably a comb over. Have you seen him?
Well, actually, he's coming here.
Really?
Yeah. Colleen talked me into inviting him, and he's willing to show me his face, and I'm going to show him mine.
Huh. Well, we both know who's getting the better end of this deal, don't we? But no, that's cool. I mean, it's a possible love connection at my first annual Halloween party. I am honored.
Giggles.
She is upstairs. She decided that she wants to keep all the chocolate and pass out socks instead. That's what she told me. And she's going to start with your drawer.
Meanwhile, Artie Animal Reed is down for the count.
Wow, wasn't this the best time of year when we were kids? I can't wait till Reed's old enough to understand it.
Yeah, when I was younger, I used to hit up the other neighborhoods for the best candy.
I bet you hip-checked all the boys and took all their candy.
Yeah, I did. You mocked me, but it worked.
Well, you know, when I was home for Halloween, my mom would always put out the best candy, and I'd always have the best costume.
Same for me when I was around. But remember, Dad never really quite seemed to make it home in time from the office.
But he'd be around now. I mean, I can imagine him pushing Reed in the stroller and hanging out with the kids. Instead, he's a...
Oh, yeah, well, that was definitely a ghost, right?
No, I think maybe I just need my sweater.
You don't believe in that stuff?
You do?
Definitely, felt Cassie's presence before.
Well, I'd like to extend an open invitation to Walter Palin.
My dad didn't kill him.
It'd be nice to hear it from the man himself.
You know who I would like to extend an open invitation to? John Jr. Kennedy. You know.
I'm because, right here. I'm sitting right here.
Well, we talk about publishing and, you know, because he was not because he was good looking.
Wow. So, no one for you?
Me? Well, I think you guys know who I might want to see.
You and Sabrina made your peace?
Yeah, I know, but I miss her. For me and for my dad.
Wow. Gotta admit, that was kind of spooky.
Oh, my gosh. What picture was that?
Whoa! What did I miss?
I don't even know how you can look at her, okay? And... never mind. Thank you for keeping her away from Daniel, by the way.
Oh, come on. I have bigger fish to fry than Amber. so do you.
You sure you don't want me to stay with you and old peg leg?
No, I'm fine. I want you to go and get pictures.
Okay.
Take a lot.
He just wants to go so he can defraud my kid of all her chocolate bars.
You should stay here, Jakey. Yeah.
You know what my husband said about my hip checking? I'm going to protect my girl, okay?
All right, man. Make sure you tell your ghost about that.
The picture slipped.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just...
Yeah, it slipped.
Yeah. Come on.
Come on, sweet.
Let's go. Let's get some candy.
Let's go.
Bye.
Let's go get chocolate. Is anybody there?
You better not tell your dad you heard me say that. Take another cranberry juice. Thank you. I didn't know you were so clumsy. Your mom's like such a tough guy.
Yeah.
Ugh, I'll take care of you.
You know, if we keep this up, we're gonna miss our reservation.
All right, well, if you wanna go eat.
You know, I don't really wanna go eat. I worry about you, sweetheart. You fashion people, you don't eat enough. And you look a little bored.
All right, I am. I'm actually trying to fight the on.
Well, all right. You can go.
Okay. Okay. He's here. Okay, be cool. I'll look for him. What's he wearing? He told me I have to figure it out. Okay, I'm gonna go, so if he wants to come up, he won't be weirded out, okay?
Okay.
Good luck. Thanks. Kiss me on my lips. We've been dancing around the moment. Now we're doing it.
You figured it out?
You're Sunny?
Yeah. It's killing me not to have you in my life. Or my days. Or my nights. When you told me about you and that internet dating site.
So you pretended to be a stranger?
Yeah. That's because no matter what, there's only you and me, sweetie.
You went all out. I'm impressed.
If you want, I can get you a pair. You can have some new headshots taken with you.
Well, those aren't very JC.
What's JC?
The girl that Sunny Crawford. Never mind. I don't know. For a second, I thought you read the book.
Tell me what it is. I'll buy it. I'll read it.
You know, I have to, excuse me.
Whoa. You don't have to go. I was just joking about the whole comb-over thing. I'm sure your man's presentable. Stick around.
No, it doesn't matter. I have to get out of here. But thank you so much for the party. Bye.
I cannot believe that Summer crashed with all that sugar in her system.
Oh, my daughter parties hard, but she sleeps harder.
Vic, you okay? You seem a little off.
Yeah, I thought I saw someone.
In our house?
No, it wasn't a person. It was like a shadow. It was like a shadow of a woman, Nora. Just out of the corner of my eye.
You know what? This is your fault and your fault. All this ghost talk has freaked her out.
All right. I'll take you home. I'll make it up to you. You can have all the candy you want. Come on.
Okay.
Is that the one Sabrina gave Reed?
It's probably just nothing. I mean, the nanny probably just had it in the diaper bag or something. It's probably nothing.
Yeah. Come on, let's get Blackbeard home.
Yeah.
Drive safe.
All right.
Did you mean what you said? You didn't think that was anything, or were you just talking Vic down?
I'm pragmatic. It was just nothing.
What about the picture and Vic's chills? What about the shadow?
Yeah. A whole lot of nothing. Don't do that to me. I'm not sharing my treats with you.
You gonna make me beg for your treats tonight? Night, ghosts.
Thank you.